My name is Joe Wiemels from the University of California, San Francisco. I'd like to talk to you a bit about genetic and epigenetic events in leukemia, and specifically the role of the timing of these events leading to a leukemia diagnosis. Today, the genetic structure of leukemias are very well understood, and we find that leukemia is actually a collection of diseases. These diseases have different genetic structures by the age of the children. So in infants, we see that most infants have leukemias with MLL translocations. That's the blue 11q23 MLL group here. Children tend to have hyperdiploidy leukemias. These are leukemias with extra five or more extra chromosomes, and 1221 tel-AML translocated leukemias. Adults have different genetic aberrations. We've been able to do some interesting studies on the timing of these genetic events in children, and we've been able to do this with the availability of Guthrie cards. Guthrie cards are samples of blood that are taken for all children immediately after birth, and they're available for all children in California. This is the way that we study the timing of origin. On the left-hand side of this slide, we see leukemia cells at the time of diagnosis. We are able to sequence the structure of the translocation. In this case, it's a tel-AML translocation in the leukemia cells, and also look back at a Guthrie or neonatal blood spot for the presence of that translocation at the time of birth. In this particular child, the translocation was found to be prenatal in origin. By now, we've studied many of these translocations or these genetic events in leukemia, and we found that the timing of their origin for most of them is prenatal. So on the left-hand side of this slide, we see a number of translocations where the first hit is prenatal. And for those leukemias, there tends to be a second hit after birth. At least one of these translocations, the E2A PBX, is actually not prenatal.